69 his ass. Damn!
How many unpopular opinions do you guys have on the Scream franchise? Surprisingly enough, fans around the world have a lot of unpopular opinions regarding Scream, and I want to share with you in this video the top 10 most unpopular opinions that I have found through social media and on my YouTube as well. Hello everyone and welcome to Beyond the Mask, where we talk about all things Scream. If you are interested in Scream content or you just like Ghostface in general, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell icon to stay notified for future content. And people have unpopular opinions online. Sometimes people choose not to air them just because you don't want to get a backlash from people who have a difference in opinion to you. And because of that very reason, some people don't necessarily air them and it's quite hard to find them. But when I set this YouTube channel up, it was more about building together a Scream community than anything else. I wanted to give you people somewhere to talk about Scream that's dedicated to just the Scream franchise. And with this video, I have taken some of the most unpopular opinions that I have found through social media and as well through the YouTube as well, through comments on polls, videos, all the discussions that I have going at the moment. It's just something that I've been wanting to do for a while, to air some opinions, but I want to know from these whether you agree with the unpopular opinion. Do you guys not agree at all? So there's 10 altogether, so let me get straight into this video by going straight to number 10. Number 10, Scream 3 is good. Scream 3 has always divided fans. Majority of people seem to like it, obviously, because we're Scream fans, but the general opinion is that Scream 3 is the least favourite amongst all of them. But someone stated on my channel that they actually really like Scream 3, that Scream 3 is one of the favourites of it. In fact, it's one of the top favourites. And they listed so many things that they enjoyed about it. For example, they enjoyed the relationship between Dewey and Gale. They also enjoyed the backstory of Amarine Prescott. And I did a poll recently asking you what your favourite aspect of Scream 3 was. And I was quite happy with the response I got. A lot of you were very kind towards Scream 3, especially in a fandom where people aren't really that friendly towards it. Number 9. The Scream franchise should have ended with the first movie. So we've had 3 sequels so far from the first Scream movie, 4 Screams altogether and a 5th on the way, but someone commented on my video a while back saying they think the film should have ended with the first one, just because the first one was meant to be in the real world, and even though it had slasher elements, it still differentiated between the reality and being a slasher movie. This unpopular opinion is that they just steered completely towards the slasher element and kept the realism out. I actually do agree with this to a point. I did feel the first Scream was far more realistic than the rest. Number 8. Scream 4 isn't as great as people think. I think despite the fact that Scream 4 didn't perform very well commercially, I do think fans do sort of embrace it as part of the Scream franchise. I actually like Scream 4, but this unpopular opinion is that Scream 4 didn't do anything new for the franchise. And from the last video that I did on Scream 4, some of your opinions were really interesting. I loved reading them because you was all kind of saying that even though you liked Scream 4, it did nothing for the franchise for you. It wasn't as great as Scream fans made out. Number 7. Tatum's death isn't well done. Tatum's garage door scene is one of the most iconic death scenes in Scream, if not the most iconic death scene, because everybody remembers Tatum in the garage. Even if you're not fans of Scream, majority of people know about the garage death with her. But someone actually said that they believed that Tatum's death was a bit spoofy, and they thought that the death was ridiculous and it took people out of the movie a little bit because the realism was stripped away in favour of this garage death scene. And another opinion on Tatum's death was that someone said they believed that the death was unnecessary because they wanted Tatum to live. Number 6. Scream 4's opening is the best. A lot of people criticised Scream 4's opening when it came out just because the idea of it being a film within a film within a film and then in the real world was taken to the extreme in Scream 4. Because of that very reason, people generally complained about it. So when I came across this comment, I was quite surprised that I read this. Someone actually said that they thought Scream 4's opening was the best out of all 4. And they thought that the continual keeping you on your toes element, that you wasn't actually sure which death was the real death of the movie, was something that they loved. And even went on to say they would love that to be an element in Scream 5, to keep viewers guessing with different stab openings. Number 5. Randy is irritating. Randy's one of my favourite characters. In fact, I thought that Scream 4 suffered because Randy wasn't in it. I was quite shocked to find this comment and someone saying they didn't like Randy, they were glad he died in Scream 2, and they found him really irritating in the movie as well. Number 4. Scream 2 and 3 are better than the original. Someone actually said that the original Scream was just too serious and was too real, and they didn't like it that much because there was hardly any deaths in it. But Scream 2 and 3 was exciting and campy, and they enjoyed the elements of those movies and how much more slasher they became. And so they stated that they enjoyed 2 and 3 far more than the first one. Number 3. Scream 2 was the first movie, but just set at college. I enjoy Scream 2, and this actual unpopular opinion, my only response to it is that that was the point. But here is the opinion. Someone said that they believed that Scream 2 was a rehash of the original Scream, and they just felt it was set at college rather than high school. All the elements were there. They went on to point out some facts, like Sydney hitting Gale was already in there, and Dewey and Gale's relationship was sort of reset again to be developed again in Scream 2, and Cece's death was basically Casey's death, only it was in a sorority house. And yeah, I sort of see the point that they're making, but that was the point of this movie. One of the killers was trying to make a sequel to the first movie, and so the killings were actually patterned from the original. Number 2. The franchise is just too proud of how meta it is. Someone stated, and I just want to put this in quotes because I found this on Screen Rant, that someone stated that they believed that Scream was too smug and proud of itself on its meta aspect. And that's kind of just saying that there's such a thing as being meta, but there's also such a thing as being too meta. And that's what they believed that Scream was. They believed that it was too self-aware, and that's something that people didn't like. Number 1. The Scary Movie ruined the seriousness of Scream. This unpopular opinion came when someone said that they thought that when they watched the original Scream, they just was taken back to Scary Movie, and all the elements that was in there and the dialogue was now considered more funny because they remembered it from Scary Movie. Surprisingly enough, some Scream fans agreed with this and said that they actually felt that that was true and that Scary Movie had tarnished the original Scream in some way. However, I don't think that's true. But it's an unpopular opinion because Scream fans came and defended the notion that Scream was ruined. They actually said that Scary Movie was two completely different movies and they shouldn't be taken in the same light at all. So there's the top 10 most unpopular opinions I have found. What do you guys think? Do you agree with this or do you not? And also, do you have any unpopular opinions yourself? Do you have anything that you want to add to this list? Comment down below and let me know. I really want to know what you think. I want to know your thoughts. And also, I want to make sure that you sort of get your voice heard. That's what this channel's for. So that Scream fans can use it as a platform to air the views and discuss the movies. So thank you very much for watching, guys. Don't forget to like this video because that really helps me out. And there's more Scream videos on my channel right now that you can check out. And it wouldn't be a video of mine if I didn't end with such an iconic quote from Scream. And I just want to point out that this is another of one of my favorites.
You know why you kill people, Roman, do you?
Don't want to hear it!
Because you choose to! There is no one else to blame!
Dad, fucking damn it!
Why don't you take some fucking responsibility?
Fuck you!
Fuck you!